So the first thing first, for this white man who are stopping us from kneeling in our own country to respect us, this marching land of a white person, a mere security guard, by virtue of being white, he thinks he's superior than even parliamentarians. He thinks the color of his skin gives him more power because he has got no regard for African black leadership. For him to respect us, we must own the land. So that when we walk in there, he knows the landlord has arrived. And the landlord you shall respect, because this is our land. But they know that we are landless. They know that we own nothing. They control the means of production. And no one respects people who do not own. Hence, the treatment of black people in USA. Can you imagine France marching and saying Black Lives Matter in France, where the reserve banks of other African countries are still being controlled from there? They are still flying every morning into some of the African countries, bread every morning, controlling the smallest opportunities, economic opportunities in those countries. Today, they want to stand with us and say to us, Black Lives Matter. We know in the EFF that Black Lives Matter, and it doesn't mean other lives do not matter. There is only one house burning, and we'll all pay attention to that house. It doesn't mean other houses are not important. They too are important, but this house is the one that is burning. So, when they killed Mr. Khoza in Alexander, the soldiers, we moved in, and we are telling you this story today reluctantly because we never wanted to tell this story. Like many other stories that we execute in the EFF, genuinely without making noise. We moved into the family. We said to them, here are the lawyers who are going to work with you to fight this government that killed a black man. We went to court, we won. The cost of the funeral and medical cost, we are now proceeding to sue government. Leave that report of the military which says the soldiers are not at fault. It's friends trying to please each other. We will meet them in a neutral court of law. They will pay this widow, they will pay this family, they will pay the children. Everyone was hurt by the nonsensical act of the military will be paid. We have assembled the best legal minds in South Africa quietly to help this family. We have also buried Khoza ourselves. We paid for the mortuary. We removed the body from here to go and be buried at home. We were supporting this family. We are not with them today because there is a hashtag Black Lives Matter. In the EFF, since we were formed, Black Lives Matters every day. Where we see an injustice, we move in there. Someone was saying, why is the EFF going to picket about issues of America? What about Khoza? Free Wi-Fi. That's a problem. Limited information. We cannot be competing with fools who thrives on hashtag so and so must fall. And whereas those falling are black people in the main. There's never been a hashtag that said Rupert must fall. There's never been a hashtag that said the Oppenheimers must fall. They've never had a hashtag that says the Minnell family must fall. All those who stole our minerals must fall. There is no such hashtag. Those who suffer from self-hate, every morning they target a black face, it must fall. This EFF is going to Pretoria. Then what about Kosaye? You are forcing us to tell you things that we don't want to talk about. Because when we help genuinely, we shouldn't even take pictures. We must help and we must be satisfied with the fact that there is a family or a person who knows that they are people who are sympathetic and who are with us during these difficult times. Black people, the black unity is very important. They will only respect us if we have unity of purpose. It is not only whites in South Africa who are racist. The Indians too are racist and don't treat our people with respect. In the continent of Africa, it's not only whites and Indians, even the Chinese have moved into our country, into our continent. They want to be the new colonizers. They are even teaching our children their own language in our own continent, yet they do not learn our own languages if they want to come and trade in Africa. So they must know, Chinese, the Indians must know that the black unity will teach them how to respect fellow human beings. We don't want a world of white, of Chinese. We want a world of humanity where we coexist as human beings, not as female, not as male, not as black, not as white.
Every politician out there who has got a better explanation that democracy will work on African ground, please come forward and challenge me on that. We can say that we are free, but our freedom is rotting, is eating, is cankering, is destroying, is vandalizing our own systems. We bring up children that we don't know. We worship what we don't know. We eat what we don't know. We work for what we don't know. We bank where we don't know our money is going. We insure our things where we don't know. We are simply an audience that is floating in the midst of a system that is being managed by those who have resources. I want to say it very clearly that poor people have no choices. Poor people have no choices. Choices are for the rich people. So show me a democratic system that allows common people to be rich. No. Democracy is actually a fine-tuned system of capitalism. Some small little elements of socialism and a little bit here and there of some hierarchical and cultural tolerance. But democracy, in all honesty, is not a system that was built by Africans, to be maintained by Africans, to be assumed by Africans. Our form of governance as Africans is Ubuntu. Ubuntu is our governance. I am because you are. It does not make sense that Africa can have so much, so many resources, yet Africa still languishes in poverty. We have banks that we don't own. We have education systems that we don't own. We have curriculums that we never wrote. We have political parties that don't service our own interest as people. We have passports. They don't give us access to other countries. They have access to our countries. We don't have access into their own countries. And that's supposed to be democracy. They have embassies in our own countries, and yet they put the same countries in sanctions. What sort of a system are we talking about if we are to be addressing the issues of African democracy? African democracy is a crippled child who is sitting on a wheelchair, a paraplegic wheelchair. Inasmuch as our countries are claimed to be democratic, they are not free at all. Our economies are ruled by the West.